My dad, Marlon D. Merrill, is a man that when you meet him, you'll never forget him.
My dad, Terry Delano, has taught me so many lessons throughout my life.
My dad's name was Alfred Jordan Kreuziger.
My dad is Chad Rowe. I know who I'm gonna be because my dad.
My father's name is Harrison David Baldwin I.
My dad's name is Andy Anderson.
If I could sum it all up in one word, it would probably be integrity.
He had been working all day, but he had promised that he would teach me how to ride a bicycle.
The best lesson he ever taught me was, if you're gonna do anything, to do it well.
One of the first things he ever taught me is to serve.
Probably the one thing that he taught me that stands out in my mind and in my heart more than anything else is to truly love people around me and truly appreciate them.
He taught me and instilled in me so many life lessons, and it has made me who I am today.
Him putting me on the bicycle, and I was nervous, like any little kid would be nervous, and he held onto the back of the bicycle, and he said, okay, Marla, just start pedaling. I've got you. I'm not gonna let go of you.
I remember going to our home church and cleaning up on Saturdays, and it was like, you know, I'm volunteering, and you need to learn. You need to volunteer at church. Because he would tell us, if you don't, you're going to go to hell. He told us that all the time, you're going to go to hell.
How to be a man that walks in honor, that walks in just integrity, that does the right thing, even when nobody's looking, that does the right thing just because it's the right thing to do.
About 2 weeks before I graduated from college, my dad was diagnosed with a malignant brain tumor. And I was getting married 2 months from that time.
He taught me boldness. He taught me to go after whatever was worth going after. He taught me unconditional love because he loved me at my worst.
My dad has shown me how to love people and have grace, because my dad has so much grace. I've never seen nobody else has much grace as my dad does.
He said he wasn't going to let go, but he let go. And I went for a little while by myself. I started screaming, realizing that he had let go. And I remember falling over, scratching up my leg, and I was bleeding. And Dad said, it's okay, get back up. We're gonna do it again. And I didn't want to. I remember crying, saying, no, I don't wanna ever ride a bike. But he told me, nope, just because you fall, you cannot quit trying.
It was a very hard time, but you know, he taught me through that. They had given him 3 to 6 months to live, so we didn't even know what condition he would be in when I got married. And he ended up living a year and a half. And he was so graceful through that period, and he was so strong.
He taught me how to love people. He taught me how to smile.
Within just a couple more tries, I was riding all around that basketball court. So what I learned from that moment with Dad was that even though I might fall, to always keep getting back up and keep going.
I just couldn't even think of a better example of how to be a man than my dad.
I volunteer because he volunteered, and he worked hard, and he taught us any job you do it well. So I work hard because of him.
I know there's nothing I can't overcome.
I would not be able to do and walk in what I do today for the kingdom if he had not modeled that in front of me.
I'm so grateful that I learned that lesson at 22, and I'm grateful for everything that he gave me in my life.
I'm so proud of him, and he's everything to me.
And I know he's watching today. And just that same encouragement that you gave me, I'm saying it to you. Get up. Get up out of that bed. Get up and start walking. Start doing the things that you know that you can do. Because people need you. I need you.
Thanks, Dad.
Thanks, Dad.
Thanks, Dad.
Thanks, Dad.
Thanks, Dad. I love you.
Thanks, Pops.